Oh, sure, there are lots of fine hibachi-style restaurants. But how many times can you watch the flaming volcano trick? Introducing Flamethrower Hibachi. Who needs a grill? At Flamethrower Hibachi, they cook it right there on your plate with a flamethrower. Flamethrower Hibachi. It's recommended all diners wear flame retardant safety gear available for a slight upcharge.
I have no eyebrows!
KHJ Los Angeles.
Portions of the day's programming are reproduced by means of electrical transcriptions or tape recording.
You're listening to the radio.
The radio program you're currently listening to is both lowbrow and esoteric at the same time.
It's just two guys making out. Relax.
Uh-oh. Sounds like somebody's got a case of the Mondays.
My name is Lester Burnham.
Now sit back, relax, and get ready to go on a musical voyage that makes Sergeant Pepper's seem like a rejected jingle for Ritz crackers.
I have got a serious case of the Mondays.
That is so stupid.
I think we're about to start a radio show.
Let's quiet down and try to be mature, okay?
Wanky, wanky, rise and shine.
Good morning, everyone.
Is it fall already?
Seasons change, young man.
The changing of the seasons.
Autumn leaves?
Falling leaves.
Oh, first day of autumn. Leaves changing beautiful colors.
Watch the leaves change.
Yeah, that happened yesterday.
Ready to get started?
Let's do this.
Okay, then, let's start the show.
Why didn't he say it's showtime? All right, whatever. Hi there. It's the Mike Show. So darned happy you could join us right here, right now on Radio 434, the Radio 434 apps, and Radio434.com. Also on the Alexa.
Hello!
How do you get our live show and our feature channel on the Alexa device, you ask? Well, I'm going to tell you. You simply enable the skill. You just do that one time. You say, Alexa, enable the Radio 434 skill, and...
Hello!
She will, and then every time after that you want to listen, you just say, Alexa, play Radio 434. That's, you just enable it one time, and then ask her to play Radio 434, and she will. You can also find our podcast on the Alexa. Now, our podcast is a repack of the live show. We do the live show from 8 to 11-ish. Sometimes we get a little bit of a late start, and that's my apologies. But we do the live show from around 8 to 11. Weekdays, Monday through Friday, and then we take all the show segments that we do and we repack it into a full-length podcast with a little commercial break in between each one of the segments instead of blocks of music, which you'll find on the live show. All right, so we repack it. You can find it on Alexa just by simply going, hey, Alexa, play the Mike Show VA podcast. And she will. You got to add that VA in there. The Mike Show VA. And you can search the Mike Show VA on Apple, Spotify, Amazon Music, RSS.com. Pretty much everywhere you get your podcasts, just search the Mike Show VA. All right. And you can watch the show segments on Facebook Live on our Facebook page at the Mike Show VA. All one word, no spaces, at the Mike Show VA. And that's good for our Instagram. It's good for our YouTube. It's good for our X or Twitter. It's good for our MySpace. We don't know how MySpace works, and I don't think we have anything up there. We might have a logo. I'm not sure, but well, here's the thing. We wanted to completely brand the Mike Show VA, all one word, no spaces, as our brand, okay? And we didn't want anybody else, snagging our brand or representing and misrepresenting us, you know, by taking our brand. So we got on everything, and MySpace is one of them. And we don't do anything with it, but maybe we should. Maybe we should, post some songs or something. It'll be nice. Let everybody know what's happening around campus. Coming up, Monday edition on the show. Of course, we're going to get smart with your five random facts. Of course, we're going to get really, really dumb with your stupid criminals in the news. And the worst drivers in America are terrorizing what state? Yeah. We have the answer, and we'll share that with you in just a few minutes. Plus, our top list, top ways to know you are a terrible, terrible driver. All right, that's all on the way. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
Looking for a dealership you can trust? CMA's Honda of Lynchburg is here for you. Our legacy of quality service speaks for itself. Drive away today in a Honda that's perfect for you. Trusted by the Lynchburg community for years. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Traveling with your family is not only affordable from Lynchburg Regional Airport, it's convenient too. Our daily departures offer easy connections on American Airlines through Charlotte to over 170 nonstop destinations. So check the great round-trip fares currently being offered to your vacation destination by using flylyh.com today and click book now. Prices are subject to change without notice and certain restrictions apply. Advanced purchase is required and availability is limited. Low fares, less hassle. Check Lynchburg first.
Join us down at the Lynchburg Community Market and experience all that one of the nation's oldest farmers markets has to offer. Grab some lunch from our restaurants and shops or shop from our awesome selection of artisan, handmade goods in our crafters gallery. Swing by on Saturday to check out our farmers market where you can shop from the freshest selection of local grown produce, meats, and more. The Lynchburg Community Market, located in downtown Lynchburg on the corner of 12th and Main Street. Open Tuesday through Saturday from 7 to 2 year-round. For more information, follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Lynchburg Community Market.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
Uh-oh, you just had an accident. At Out-of-Pocket Insurance, we take the hassle out of filling out a bunch of online forms. And just like a lot of insurance companies, you'll never meet us, talk to us, or even have an online chat. We don't even have offices or agents around town. Hey, you don't like hassles, and neither do we. So sign up today, and the next time you're in an accident...
Oh, man, I'm sorry. My bad. I got out-of-pocket insurance.
I got out-of-pocket insurance.
Oh, so we're good, right?
Yeah.
Take it easy.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Out-of-pocket insurance.
Mm-hmm. The Mike Show. Didn't we have another one? We had another sponsor there. Here we go.
This show was made possible by your fellow drivers. Mm-hmm. Sorry we're all driving like idiots.
Yep.
And yes, we promise to watch the road.
Yeah. Really? Okay. So, no one raves about the other drivers on their morning commute, but are you part of the problem? Well, a new survey asked people from all 50 states to assess their own driving habits. They didn't just ask for an overall grade. They actually asked people if they were guilty of 19 different bad driving habits. And these are things like speeding, 10 miles over the speed limit or less, or extreme speeding, or eating and driving, texting while driving, not using your turn signal, road rage, tailgating, and running red lights. 89% of drivers in Hawaii consider themselves to be good drivers. Sounds pretty good, but it's actually the lowest among all states. Hawaii has the self-professed worst driving habits. Oregon is second worst, followed by New Mexico, Wyoming, Alaska, North Dakota, Connecticut, Vermont, Kansas, and West by God, Virginia. The majority of states admitted to the same top three bad behaviors. Speeding, 10 miles per hour over the speed limit or less. Eating while driving. Speeding up, going through red lights, or yellow lights, rather. Oklahoma was the only state where they admitted texting and driving made the top three worst habits. And by the way, this is arguably the most dangerous bad habit. And so maybe people are less likely to admit to it. I don't know. Drivers in Tennessee say they're the least worst drivers, followed by Ohio, Pennsylvania, Florida, Georgia, Arizona, Michigan, Delaware, South Dakota, and North Dakota. Now, I hesitate to say best drivers because, again, this data is based on admitted bad habits. So maybe drivers in Hawaii are just the most honest. And maybe drivers in Tennessee are the most delusional. Chevy drivers, according to the survey, were the worst. Oh, yeah. Well, they admitted to having bad driving habits, most likely, followed by GMC and Buick drivers. All three, it's the same company. Chrysler drivers and Dodge drivers after that. Overall, 94% of people in the survey consider themselves to be good drivers, including a whopping 96% of men, of course. So, that brings us to our top list. With a new survey finding the worst drivers in America are in Hawaii, but you don't have to live in the Aloha State to be a hellion on the highway, especially if you relate to anything on today's list. It's our top list today. Top ways to know you're a terrible driver. All right, here we go. Number one, people compare you to Tiger Woods, and you don't play golf. Yep. You learned how to drive with a deployed airbag. Allstate slogan is you're in good hands, except for Doug. Top ways to know you're a terrible driver. Your hands aren't at 10 and 2, but your knees are at 7 and 5. Your shoulder has seat belt burns. Seat belt burns. Duct tape holds together the duct tape, holding together the duct tape, holding together your side mirror. Top ways to know you're a terrible driver. You have a Mustang on your grill because you actually hit a Mustang. Top ways to know you're a terrible driver. Crash test dummies study how you survive impacts. And it's our top list today. Top ways to know you're a terrible driver. Your car is red. And it's not from the paint. Oh, my. That's frightening. All right, The Mike Show, Monday edition of the program. Coming up, we've got news and not headline news. That's all on the way. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by Lynchburg Regional Airport. It is so much easier to fly LYH.
Making sure that you never miss that important connection. At Lynchburg Regional Airport, we're ready when you're ready.
4 bags to check in, please.
LYH. From here to there to anywhere. We're ready when you're ready.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing Community, Three Roads Brewery.
From brand new to lightly used, CMA's Honda of Lynchburg's got you covered. Shop our growing selection today and find our best deals on our entire inventory. That's savings on every single vehicle. And on our used cars, take 3 days to love it or leave it. Plus, we'll buy your current vehicle. Trade in with us and get an unbeatable offer. Start shopping and saving today. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF.
This is not headline news. Today is Redhead Appreciation Day. I've always wondered, if you happen to dye your hair red, does that make you transgendered? The Matlock reboot debuted last night on CBS. Fans of the original would be excited if it weren't for the fact that all of them died about 20 years ago. Microsoft will reopen Three Mile Island to power AI technology. Locals give the decision 3 thumbs up. Bruce Springsteen turns 75 today. He releases a new single, Born to Mall Walk. And Joan Jett turned 66 yesterday, which explains her new song, I Love Yacht Rock and Roll. This is not Headline News.
Good Lord, it's not. It's The Mike Show. So happy you could join us right here on the program. All right, let's see. Let's talk in-laws. So if you have a good relationship with your in-laws, you either are very, very lucky or very patient, or they're very patient. I don't know. A poll commissioned by Newsweek found the average American clashes with their in-laws at least once a month. Around 1 in 6 said more than that. Can you guess the number one thing that we're most likely to fight about? Well, here's a hint. It's probably the top thing your in-laws fight about on Facebook, too. Yep, you guessed it. Politics. Yeah, I said politics. Where's the thing? I want the... Where is my clown horn? Oh, man, I can't find my clown horn. Okay, I'm going to look for that. I didn't say clown porn. I said clown horn.
Nice beaver.
Yeah, thanks.
Thank you. I just had it stuffed.
Let me help you with that.
Anyway, okay, take two. It would be politics. 31% of people have argued about it with their in-laws. Let's go from the bottom up for the other four. We got the top five. Parenting decisions, 18%. Yeah. Okay. So, we're kind of blessed. Well, I'm kind of blessed, because, Tab's dad, I said Tab's dad. Tab's dad is such a patient man, and he's a lovely person. Okay. Tab's mom, on the other hand, well, I mean, she was wonderful too, but she was very gregarious and was always pushing buttons and parenting decisions. I would say, yeah, I agree with that. Number five, 18%. Now, you would expect it to be higher, but not everybody in the survey, I guess, had kids. Number four on the list was money, 19%. You might be fighting about that. Disputes about your partner, 21%. They didn't go into a deeper dive on that. And lifestyle choices, 22% have arguments with their in-laws about lifestyle choices. A third said they wouldn't vacation with their in-laws because things most likely would go south. 27% doubt they could even enjoy a weekend together. Yikes. All right. Do we have one more? How about this? So, is it weird to still struggle with the concept that you learned in kindergarten? A lady on TikTok is going viral after admitting that she still has trouble knowing her left from her right. I said she has trouble knowing her left from her right. She saw a video where someone said left to right are just as intuitive to them as up and down. But she has to think about it first, and she thought everybody had to think about it. So is this common? Is it a common issue for adults? Now, I've always shown this to my kids. You know, if it's an L, that's your left, and if it's not, that's your right. A few people in the comments made fun of her, or thought she was joking. One person said they genuinely don't understand how grown adults get confused by left and right. But plenty of people, there's a lot. You know, when we were kids, growing up, they weren't testing for dyslexia. They weren't, so there's a lot of issues that adults face that are not necessarily just a kid thing. They just didn't test for that when we were kids. So there are issues. Plenty of people said they have to think about it too, and it's not something that's just automatic. One person said they still have to do a trick, the same trick that I just did, where they put their thumb and pointer finger out, and if it looks like an L, that's your left. All right, coming up, we are going to get really smart with your five random facts. That's all on the way. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by Jersey Mike Subs. I want to thank Jersey Mike Subs for sponsoring the lunch at the Mods and Rockers scooter rally, which we held at Three Roads. It was really, really cool. We had an incredible day on Saturday, and tons of folks came out from all over the country to enjoy Lynchburg and the surrounds. They had all kinds of activities and games for scooter riders as well. Even gave away a scooter. It was a Honda scooter. That was one of the raffle items. And it was a fundraiser for the United Way of Central Virginia. Very, very happy that we could host it at Three Roads and that I could come out and MC it. It was a lot of fun. And a big thanks to, again, Jersey Mike Subs for hooking us up with the lunch. I had Jersey Mike's. Okay, wait. I had Jersey Mike's on Friday with my daughter, my youngest. She got out of school early. She had early dismissal. So we went to Jersey Mike's. So that was Friday. And then while I was picking up the subs for the Mods and Rockers event, I ordered yet another Mike's Famous Philly for my lunch on Saturday. It was just amazing. I had Jersey Mike's back to back. It was wonderful. Just absolutely wonderful. But we want to thank them. Also want to thank the band Old Town Connector for coming out and being our band. They were just incredible. And the storm that hit Saturday night, we were watching it and watching it and watching it on radar. And according to radar, it was not going to hit. I said it was not going to hit at our location at Three Roads or in downtown. But then all of a sudden, there was just a bunch of flashes of lightning. The wind picked up, and we all knew. And so we had the band and everything, really, set up outside. And everybody chipped in, and everybody grabbed some equipment, and everybody took it inside the tap room at Three Roads. And we set up the band. Like 10 minutes later, we were back at it. So we moved the party inside, and it was a lot of fun. So if you were out and you joined us, thank you so much. And if you were not, well, you missed a heck of a party. But program note and event note coming up on the 28th. That's this Saturday. Yeah, we have the band Full Moon Fever is going to be performing, and we're celebrating the Virginia 10 Miler with the 11th Mile After Party in Three Roads and us. We are bringing in the band Full Moon Fever from Richmond. They are the Tom Petty tribute band. They're incredible. We're going to have the big stage. We're going to have the big lights and the big sound system set up for you. And festivities get underway with kind of a Virginia 10 Miler mixer, meet and greet from 3 to 6. They'll do some of the awards award presentations there between that time, and then Full Moon Fever with an opening act. We'll start at right around 6 o'clock or so, and everyone is invited. It's open to the public. It is kid friendly. It's pet friendly. Family friendly. Just bring a lawn chair, bring a blanket, or whatever you want to sit on. And admission is absolutely positively free. So it's open to the public. You don't have to have been a runner. You don't have to have been part of the Virginia 10 Miler. This is a Three Roads jam. So we invite you to come out and enjoy a free concert event with Full Moon Fever on Saturday night. All right. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by Jersey Mike Subs.
At Jersey Mike's, they slice your order fresh right in front of you. And let me tell you, watching that can send a rush of emotions through a person. Excitement, impatience, baby-like wonder, indecisive, anticipatory chewing, nervous pacing, happy claps, and finally, jealousy, because that's this guy's sub. I should order one. Good idea.
Sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Lynchburg Regional Airport is going strong. For many years now, Lynchburg's low fares have been among the most competitive in the area, and our conveniently scheduled flights offer easy connections on American Airlines through Charlotte to over 170 nonstop destinations worldwide. So check the great round-trip airfares currently being offered by visiting flylyh.com today and click Book Now. Prices are subject to change without notice and certain restrictions apply. Advance purchases required and availability is limited. Your close and convenient connection, check Lynchburg first.
Hi, I'm Megan Huffman with Share Greater Lynchburg. Share is an online platform that helps neighbors discover ways to support, serve, or shop for over 150 local area nonprofits all in one place, 365 days a year. You can learn more at sharegreaterlynchburg.org.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF!
And now it's time for
Random Facts.
Yep, that time of the day we cram your head full of usable information, and you can tell it back wherever the heck you happen to be. We don't know where you go or what you do, and quite frankly, it's really none of our business. But if you say any of these five random facts back, someone in the room is bound to say,
wow.
Maybe, I don't know. All right, here we go. Number one, black widow spiders. I said black widow spiders are not very aggressive. You often have to pinch or squeeze one to get it to attack. Squeeze your black widow spider. But their venom makes bites very, very painful, and to small animals like mice, fatal. Number two, the average person will take about 216.3 million steps in their lifetime, which is the equivalent of walking all the way around the earth five times. That assumes the average active person takes around 7,500 steps per day. Number three, the first college football All-American team was picked in 1889, and the quarterback was a player from Princeton named Edgar Allan Poe. He was second cousins with the author Edgar Allan Poe, and he was named after him. Number four, generally, PG-13 movies are allowed to use the F word once, only if it's used in anger and doesn't directly refer to sex. And then number five, let's get some music in the background here. Here we go. Number five, Martha Stewart once dated Anthony Hopkins, but she broke up with him because she couldn't stop associating him with Hannibal Lecter from The Silence of the Lambs. Can you imagine if he was just torturing her like that, and he would constantly go into the Hannibal character? Sorry. And those are your five random facts.
This has been today's edition of
1, 2, 3, 4, 5
random facts.
Yep. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by CMA's Honda of Lynchburg.
Looking for a dealership you can trust? CMA's Honda of Lynchburg is here for you. Our legacy of quality service speaks for itself. Drive away today in a Honda that's perfect for you. Trusted by the Lynchburg community for years. CMA's Honda of Lynchburg. Owners just care more.
Join us down at the Lynchburg Community Market and experience all that one of the nation's oldest farmers markets has to offer. Grab some lunch from our restaurants and shops, or shop from our awesome selection of artisan, handmade goods in our crafters gallery. Swing by on Saturday to check out our farmers market, where you can shop from the freshest selection of local grown produce, meats, and more. The Lynchburg Community Market, located in downtown Lynchburg on the corner of 12th and Main Street. Open Tuesday through Saturday from 7 to 2 year-round. For more information, follow us on Facebook and Instagram at Lynchburg Community Market.
You gotta love the juice at Jersey Mike's. That zing of real red wine vinegar and olive oil blend is even better than the zing of a first kiss. No offense to Brenda DeMarche. It was a fine first smooch for me behind the bleachers. But there's nothing like when that zing of the juice hits your lips for the very first time.
Years later, Brenda and I shared a Jersey Mike's sub with extra juice. We had a better time because neither of us had braces.
Add a flavor zing with the juice. Jersey Mike's. A sub above.
Broadcasting from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry shops, Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their factory direct warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF. All right, let's open it up. It's your audio vault for today. Our collection of bits and clips and viral audio for your ear holes. I think you'll like it. Well, modern day criminals are ruining our day-to-day lives. Because of them, a lot of stuff is locked up in stores, and you have to ask a store employee to open the case for simple things.
And now thoughts from the teeth whitener locked behind plexiglass at Target.
Man, I hate being in mouthwash prison. I give people a white smile. Why am I stuck in the green mile? I don't get it. People keep stealing us, but we get punished. As my cellmate Speedstick put it, the whole thing stinks. I mean, come on. Why not lock up the ramen? It's always getting in hot water. Uh-oh, somebody started a riot in the makeup block. Maybe it's Maybelline. When will someone bust me out?
Hey, can you open this one for me?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Hey, dude, get me out of here. Oh, wait, he's in a WrestleMania tank top. He doesn't care about his teeth.
Those were thoughts from the teeth whitener locked behind plexiglass at Target.
It was. Okay, so how's this for a rare music find? A previously unknown work, allegedly by a teenage Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, was discovered. It was from the mid to late 1760s and performed for the first time ever on Saturday. I think we have a clip. Yeah, I don't think that's it. All right, who's bad? You guys. All right, let's go to viral videos. The official TikTok for Nutter Butter, have you checked this out? The cookies is going viral because it's completely unhinged. Somebody posted a video asking if the folks at Nutter Butter are okay. Every video is like a fever dream or a bad acid trip.
If you guys have not seen Nutter Butter's official account, I'm concerned. Nutter Butter, are you guys okay?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So they appear to be homemade. One of them has Nutter Butter misspelled as Nutter Butter with one T on each. Man, oh, man. Okay. Parents, I know that you have to go through this. If your kids have lizards or turtles as pets, sometimes the little kids like to take them to school in their backpack. Just make sure to check their backpack before, because this elementary school teacher heard scratching sounds from a student's backpack. And here, listen.
Open it. I volunteer you.
I think it's a live turtle.
No!
Look in the back part of his backpack, in the very back. Oh my god!
It's a live turtle in there.
Oh my god, the poor thing. Why is it in there? When you're sitting with your coworker getting some work done and you hear some clawing in a backpack.
All right, a driver in Florida spotted an SUV placed directly on top of a dumpster. Now, it wasn't the result of a wild crash or anything. Just some construction workers put it up there temporarily with a forklift because it was in the way, apparently. Here is one of the witnesses of the crazy sight talking about it.
I text my buddy. I'm like, is that fair game? Is that free? It's in the dumpster? You know, I was like, I wasn't sure. I had to do it like a double take. And I seen a car on top of a dumpster. I'm like, are you serious? So I'm just driving, went to Publix, I snapped a picture. And then on the way back, I stopped, took a little video.
AI generated images of purple apples that are allegedly from Saskatchewan, Canada, are popping up, and people are asking orchards for the fruit. Now, these are just AI generated images. Apparently, though, it's just a fake. that has gone viral and it's tricking people. Here is Rachel or Rochelle Hoffmeister, a horticulturalist at Dutch Growers, talking about the purple apples.
It would be so fun, but unfortunately, it is not real.
You can have purple leaves on the crab apples.
When there's an AI-generated photo that pops up online, we always get lots of inquiries.
Let's see. Are we going to comedian? Yep. We wrap up Audio Vault with a comedian, and today is no exception. For Redhead Appreciation Day today, here's ginger-haired comedian Matt Clemens.
I am fair-skinned. I have a red hair. You guys might guess I have orange hair. People make fun of me for my hair color. They call me names like Carrot Top, which I really don't understand, you know, because I don't make fun of other people for their hair color, you know. Uncle people with brown hair call them a poopy head. Uncle very blonde girl, he say, hey, tramp. And then I'll go with people with black hair and say, hey, your hair must like dating fat white chicks. I don't say those things. I'm a gentleman.
All right, that's your audio vault for today. Let's reach over here, lovingly grab the handle, and go ahead, give it a tug. Keep all that sound inside. Coming up, we have, we're going to get even more stupider with your stupid criminals in the news. And then we've got a good news story for you as well. This portion of our broadcast is brought to you in part by Lynchburg Regional Airport. It is so much easier to fly LYH.
Whether your adventure is just beginning or you're on your way home, at Lynchburg Regional Airport, we're ready when you're ready. LYH. From here to there to anywhere. We're ready when you're ready.
Hi, I'm Matt Bright, the new owner of CRI Digital Impressions. And I'm excited to announce a new chapter in the century-long history of CRI. Mutual Press was founded in 1927, and in 1973 it merged with CRI to become CRI Mutual Press. In 2002, it was renamed CRI Digital Impressions. I also own Bright Images, which has provided print and media services to the area since 1995. Yes, there is a new owner and a new location, but the same commitment to quality and service. In fact, quality and service are the cornerstones of my business philosophy. Quick turns and service with a smile. From business cards to banners and pamphlets to paperback books, we can provide all your printing needs. Call, visit us online, or stop by our location at 3022 Memorial Avenue, Lynchburg. We look forward to serving you.
Three Roads Brewery is Lynchburg's gathering spot. Enjoy the relaxed open atmosphere of the Lynchburg Tap Room with plenty of space to unwind or outside on their expansive patio with friends and the entire family. Check out Three Roads games, arcade style, darts, and more. And of course, an excellent selection of craft beers brewed on site. Grab a Three Roads today at their tap room, 1300 Court Street, downtown Lynchburg, their tap room in Farmville, or anywhere they serve great beer. Three Roads is also available at area convenience stores and supermarkets. And if they don't carry Three Roads, ask them to. Brewing community. Three Roads Brewery.
Coming to you live from the Stonecrafter Studios. For custom countertops and cabinetry, shop Stonecrafter's incredible inventory at their Factory Direct Warehouse, 3678 Manita Road, Bedford. Online at stonecraftersva.com.
KHF! Oh, hi there. Time once again for Stupid Criminals in the News. This is kind of interesting. Every now and then you hear about a mystery that would be perfect for a TV detective. Somebody in California had their car broken into on Friday the 13th. They were parked outside of a school and had gone inside the gym with their kid. When they noticed, they came back to the car. They saw the back passenger window had been shattered. And when they looked inside, they noticed that there was at least one thing missing. Was a cardboard box that the owner said contained $1 million. First off, why would you have a cardboard box containing $1 million in your car that and you're dropping your kid off and you're going inside the gym? I don't know. Maybe the guy's a multimillionaire. Who knows? But anyway, police also say they discovered a GPS device attached to the car. This is, starting to get good. I mean, it was attached to their
automobile.
The victim didn't seem to be aware of the GPS device. Suddenly, this break-in is a lot more interesting. But unfortunately, there aren't any more details. Police are investigating both the break-in and the claim that there was $1 million in cash
automobile
inside their automobile. And then there is this, not an automobile, but a bucket truck.
Automobile?
A bucket truck, I said. a Spectrum worker in North Carolina parked his bucket truck on the side of the road, a utility worker, the other day while working on power lines. He was up in the bucket when a random guy jumped in the driver's seat and stole the truck and started speeding down the road with the boom arm extended.
Go!
The guy drove more than half a mile before crashing on the side of the road. The boom hit a power line, caused a utility pole to snap. The worker apparently got tossed from the bucket, but had a safety strap on that saved him. He ended up cutting the strap to free himself and hurt his leg when he fell.
I've been up 80 feet, and you're that far up in the air, just the wind can shift and make you move, rock back 2 or 3 feet. He had to be terrified.
I feel for that person's family. You know, he was just doing what he was supposed to do.
Now, the moron who stole the truck is an older guy named Frank Moody. He'd just been released from jail 2 hours earlier. He's facing charges for larceny of a motor vehicle and assault with a deadly weapon. Let's look at what he looks like. Let's share Mr. Moody's mugshot. We rarely ever do this, but there you go. There's Mr. Moody. Are we going to good news? Do we have good news? Yes. There's good news in the world, and we like to share it during this particular segment. I kind of want to do both of these good news stories, because this one it's kind of an important story to share. And then the other one's about cats. Atrium Health is a healthcare system that owns a bunch of hospitals in North Carolina and Georgia. And just announced that they're forgiving more than 11,000 people's old medical debt. NBC News did a story this month on how the company was aggressively pursuing debt. They even put liens on people's homes. So I guess they got publicity shamed for it. Looks like it worked. Here's Terry Belk, one of the customers that got his debt canceled, talking about the good news.
It feels great because you know that the way to build wealth for most Americans is through their home. So for almost 2 decades, I had that taken from me. Well, he said that I had been through a lot and that they're moving forward in a new direction as it relates to, you know, patient care and outcome, that they're going to be lifting liens and counseling judgments on all ex-patients.
All right. A couple from Northern California took their cat on a camping trip to Yellowstone, and he ran off. But he just showed back up 2 months later at a shelter in Salinas, California, 800 miles from where he went missing. Here's the owner, Suzanne here's Suzanne talking about the story.
He was really depleted. He probably didn't have a lot of energy to maybe even go further. So this lady who found him and rescued him, she's just an angel because she said that he looked like he was not going to make it much longer.
And there you go. That is the good news. The good news is brought to you in part by the United Way of Central Virginia.
Well, being on the board is an amazing experience because you get to find out a lot about the community and what the needs of the community are. United Way is in the business of changing lives.
43,669 of our neighbors cannot afford the basic costs of living. United Way programs were able to provide 99,500 meals to families.
I am the change.
Visit our website, Be the Change, and donate today.
Visit UnitedWayCV.org for more information. All right. Well, that is it. That is the program. We are back tomorrow.
Goodbye.
Don't come back.
Now we're back tomorrow with another thrilling edition of The Mike Show. Have a great day, everybody.
Thanks for tuning our way. And if you're listening in your car right now, thanks for the ride.
Scotty, beam me up.
We'll see you here again tomorrow.
Who's going to do the dishes?